last night, we carried the story of a shooting incident where a senior police officer was killed, reportedly by his colleague while on a rescue mission. Tonight, KTN has established that the rescue mission, as claimed by the police, may not have occurred, and neither did the kidnapping. Here's KTN's Dennis Onsarigo with a story.
Zebedeo Maina joined the National Police Service straight from high school. The junior officer, described as a quiet, quick but temperamental, became a favorite of many bosses in the several police squads he served in. But Maina's influence started waning after the government disbanded his killer squad that had at times been linked to criminal activities in the country. Tracking down Mungiki sect members turned into a vicious cartel, where the crack unit openly extorted thousands of shillings from family members in exchange for freedom for their sons. Maina faded from the public limelight, got transferred to Bungoma and later Kitui town, where he met his death. His killing sparked off murmurs that the soft-spoken but ruthless cop may have been silenced. KTN reconstructs the scene of a shooting that appears as a well-crafted killing of an officer who had done all the dirty work for the police establishment. A mechanic who saw the events unfold told the police a different story from the one that a report forwarded to the director of public prosecutions contained a few days after Zebedeo Maina was killed. The mechanic says he saw a motor vehicle pull over outside this building and out emerged a man. The man crossed the street, but not before another man approached him and asked him to identify himself. The man reached for his gun, but before he could use it, another man shot him from the back. The man who pulled out his gun was Zebedeo. Zebedeo was shot and lay in a pool of blood just meters away from the building. The mechanic says the man hurriedly collected the spent cartridges from the scene of the shooting and left. A statement penned by a police officer who took part in the rescue mission says two vehicles pulled over outside this building and out came two men from one of the cars. The man was Zebedeo Maina and his colleague, both armed with guns. After a few minutes, Zebedeo confronted one of the kidnappers and wrestled him before his colleague emerged from the car. The colleague, a fellow police officer, while trying to rescue Maina, accidentally shot him. Maina fell on his back. KTN has since established that there was no confrontation between the alleged kidnappers or accidental shooting of Maina by his colleague that the police later revealed was Corporal Justice Wendot. The rescue mission was stage managed. The kidnapping never took place, and the killing of Zebedeo Maina appears to have been planned for a long time. Who wanted Zebedeo Maina? A police officer linked to the killing of the former Mungiki leader, Maina Njenga's wife, dead. And why? KTN's investigations desk met up with a man police say was the alleged kidnapper. The man who works as a driver of a local church in Kitui says he was ambushed by a man while walking on the street.
Niko chini. Saizo niko chini. Nimeanguka ni vile nimeangalia kale. Nikiwa hapo chini tu. kadere ameangushwa bidua macho pande hii na huyo mwingine ameanguka pande hii nyingine na sikujua ameshotiwa na nani
yeye ndiye alikuwa amekushika mbele
sasa wakati nilianguka
yes
nilikanyangwa chini nilikanyangwa
huyo mwenye alikupiga geta ni nani ni huyo mwenye amekukanyaga sahihi ama ni huyo mwenye ameanguka.
The driver does not wish his identity revealed, says he did not engage minor in any confrontation. He did not witness who shot him, but he saw him lie on the ground and heard him asking for help.
Sisi tuliwekwa kwa buti na hatukujua aliwekwa wapi. Ile alipigwa risasi.
Lakini ulisikia akisema nipeleke hospitali. Alafu akasema nini hao?
Hawakusema chochote. Sisi tuliwekwa kwa buti. Na hatukujua kama amechukuliwa kaya kwa hiyo ama alibebwa na ingine. Hatukujua vile tulifungiwa kwa buti. Situ kaenda.
The driver was later charged in court way before any statement was taken from him.
Na huyu mkubwa wa CID kutoka Nairobi, wakati aliniita pale kwa ofisi, aliniambia sababu ya kuniuliza mimi, alikuwa anataka kujua yule askari yule alimuua. Hiyo ndio aliniambia kila kitu ameshapata. Ile alikuwa anataka kujua ni yule askari aliuawa na nani. Kama niliona yule aliuawa huyo askari tu.
Tukasema
nikamwambia mimi nilisikia milipuko mbili. Na sikujua aliuawa na nani. Sijui ni huyo amenikanyaga ama ni yule mwingine.
The charges were hurriedly withdrawn 4 days later. KTN has learned that Maina was rushed to a local dispensary for treatment. The team reportedly told the hospital staff they had just shot a suspect whom they wanted attended to. Maina succumbed to his injuries moments later at Kitui District Hospital. In a twist of events, the alleged kidnappers, according to the police later that night, called the mother of the kidnapped child and released the 5-year-old to her. According to the police, the mother send the kidnapper some money as ransom fee.
Tukiwa hapo kuna mwanamke tulisikia akiongea kwa gari huko ni pale ya mbele huko kuna viti alikuwa anasema unajua huko ni kumbaya kumeruka sana huyo mwanamke aliongea wakati hiyo gari ilisimama ikafunguliwa milango tukasikia watu wale walikuwa ndani wametoka.
What is shocking, despite the killing of one of their own, the mother, the center of the kidnapping, did not care to inform the police about the arrangement she had made with the kidnappers. The identity of the mother and the kidnapped child has not to date been made public either. KTN has learned that 2 weeks before, Zebedeo Maina, linked to several state-sponsored killings, had complained to his seniors about threats on his life. A team of senior police officers, among them the head of the investigations at the CID headquarters, Mohamed Amin, Kingori Mwangi, the deputy director of police reforms, were among the first people to arrive in Kitui town after the shooting. The team interrogated those suspected of kidnapping and the police officers involved in the shooting. A report compiled by the investigating team blamed a junior police officer for the killing and went ahead to recommend for his prosecution. The director of public prosecutions appears to have agreed with the investigating team when Dot was the man who killed his colleague. The presence of a Mr. Mwangi, a training instructor at the traffic headquarters who was helping the Nairobi team track down the would-be kidnappers, has not been explained. What was a training instructor doing leading a rescue mission in Kitui town? The identity of the woman whose child had been allegedly kidnapped also remains mysterious. Senior police officers have told KTN the kidnapping theory might have been a plot to lure Maina to his death. Police in Kitui told us they were planning to prosecute the mother of the kidnapped child, but almost a month later, nothing has moved. Close friends to Zebedeo Maina have told KTN the slain police officer carried out high-profile assignments for the government of the day. Was Maina's killing accidental, or did the soft-spoken man walk into a deadly trap? Denis Onsarigo, KTN Prime.